Well, Arya's gonna come back from her praying.
Okay, here we go.
And she's gonna say, "Well, I've done it."
40 d20s. That's a bunch.
Done what?
I have a way we can hide from the skeletons.
Oh.
Yeah.
She does.
I have a spell here.
What do you mean?
It's called Hide from Undead. I can cast it on all of us, and they won't detect us.
Well, bloody hell.
Wait, are you telling me that we can just walk in the front gate and not have to climb?
Maybe.
How long will we be hidden?
We will be hidden for
90 minutes, hour and a half. However,
son of a bitch.
Also, I'm gonna lean in and heal each of them moderately.
Just when I thought you couldn't do anything stupider, you go and do something like this and totally redeem yourself. Okay, so what it does is, basically that spell, Hide from Undead. Undead can't hear you, they can't see you, they can't smell you. Even extraordinary. However, intelligent undead make willpower saves to see through it.
Gotcha.
So just bear that in mind. It's not a catch-all. But dumb as shit undead are automatically affected.
18 for each of you.
There we go.
There you go. Little touch-up from Arya's ambulance.
Well, I'm almost at full health. Thank you.
Me too, thank you.
Well, Arya, I see. If we go towards the front and see if the gate is open, and then you cast your little awesome spell of awesome.
Sure. Is it nighttime now?
If you guys are going to stay here and wait all throughout the day to nighttime, I can roll some random encounters for you. Yeah. If you're waiting all day here in the woods.
Well,
do we want to go in versus the daylight?
Well, honestly,
they can't detect us.
If they can't detect us unless they're, you know...
Yeah, but didn't we see figures on top of the bridge, too?
Yes, you did.
Well, we'll kill them later.
You might actually be able to see what those are now. It's daylight.
Yeah.
That'd be interesting.
All right, so you guys are going to make your way back to the edge of the clearing to look, or are you just going to stay here?
Yeah, on the west side. That's what I'm suggesting.
The west side.
I'm voting that we wait till darkness.
West side!
Okay, so you don't want to go and take a squiz in daylight. You don't want to risk it.
All right, so let's...
But I am but one vote.
Okay.
Well, it's up to Arya, because I vote we go.
Oh, Arya's the swing vote. Ba-ba-ba-bum.
I vote.
We chase fluffy kittens!
But we go up to the tree line just to see if we can tell what the other creatures were before we attack tonight.
Okay, so you guys, you're going to sneak up, just take a look, and then come back.
Just take a peek, and then...
Alrighty then. Let's do that. That sounds fun.
Son of a bitch.
That's twice he said that.
Son of a bitch. I got Royal Tenenbaums on my mind. I'm sorry.
That's funny.
Alright, hold on a second. So let me line this up for you guys. So you want to get like over here more where you can actually see the bridge?
Yeah.
All right. Let's zoom in a little for you guys. Oh, come on, Roll20. Stop being evil.
Evil.
An evil vet? An evil petting zoo? Okay.
You always do that.
Okay. From where you guys are, you can see, so you are looking, but it is broad daylight. 510 feet.
Wow.
Yep, there's figures up there.
So kind of looking, you can see, and Boombox, thanks for that kind donation. Awesome sauce, thanks, and we'll read that donation. Did we have a donation from last time?
Maybe? We'll go through them all.
Did we miss
later?
One? Well, let me check, because... No, we got it. We got it. Okay, it's good.
Can I take some parchment and like roll it up and then, you know...
Right, pretend you have an eyeglass? Okay. Yeah. From this distance, basically what you're seeing... You can tell readily enough that the way they are standing, the way they're moving, it's not likely that they're undead. They are larger than the average human, they're very bulky, and they are armored. Each one of them looks like it has a heavy crossbow up there, and there are four of them. Two of them are facing in this direction, the other two look like they're probably facing the other way.
I say we wait. Cat butt.
Cat butt height.
Sorry.
Okay, so now you guys want to wait it out until...
Yep, let's do that.
Whereabouts are you going to want to go? Where are you planning on coming out at nighttime? Back where you were?
Well, Veslar was thinking over here to see the front entrance. Well, is there no front entrance?
Well, you don't know yet.
I hate this place. Yep, okay.
Shoot. I hate you guys.
Okay, from here, yeah, I mean, your view is pretty much obscured by this tower.
I'm going to skirt up along the edge of the tower and peek.
Oh, so you actually go... So is, now you're doing this now, or you wait until nighttime?
Nighttime.
Okay. So you...
That's what I'll do at nighttime. Yeah.
Okay, right. Well, you are unaccosted during the day by anything unpleasant, so let's go ahead and zoom in so that everyone gets a better view. Okay, here you go. Alrighty. So you emerge, like, you come out of the main tree line to this small crop of trees here. Okay. And then what are you going to do?
Well, I want to see the front.
Okay, so move. Show me where you're moving to.
Along the forest, the edge, right?
Okay, so you're following the edge of the forest.
As far as it goes, pretty much, so I can see around this little turret. This little embattlement.
Right. Okay. Bearing in mind it's pitch black, and of course, well, I say pitch black, pitch purple. It looks like right here, at the very top, there is a doorway. However, it is 160 feet up the side of the cliff.
Let's climb it.
Looks like it is a some kind of, obviously it must kind of come down like some kind of steep ramp, but it is raised right now.
Oh, you're talking like right here.
Right here. Oh, hold on. Let me give you a ping.
Ah. Oh.
Right here, there would actually be like a huge, big, long drawbridge that would come down. Now, looking across from there, like over here, that's kind of like where, you know, it's all open. So this thing probably comes all the way down at a very steep angle and hits the ground probably 160 feet across. So you're probably looking at, yeah, like three times that. But it is raised right now. So unless you can think of a way to get it lowered.
We can leave a giant horse as a gift and we can hide inside the horse.
We could build this great big wooden badger.
Brilliant.
Okay.
No, we didn't check to see if it was down during the day.
Right. That would have been smart.
More screams.
More screaming from inside. Like somewhere deep inside the fortress.
I just look at Piper and Arya and shrug and be like, I don't know what to do.
Cat's only seen something. He's gotta be over here.
The only thing I could think of is it go down in the day, wait till day, but, you know.
No, we're not waiting another day.
Yeah, I mean, there was a level of urgency applied. How much urgency is really kind of...
Yeah.
You know what I wish we could do is summon the boar again and mage hand it up.
I just like you to summon the boar.
You just want the boar to
mage
fly.
Hand at 160 feet. Let it fall and see how much damage it takes, just for fun. A completely you know, heinous waste of magic. It would be hilarious.
Yeah.
Can't handle.
Stop it, Coley.
Just in case you guys don't know, if you've seen the Harry Potter movie where Harry Potter lives in the basement, that's where Jane Ivana lives. She lives in a basement in her cruel step aunt's house, and the only thing she has to keep her company is that cat.
The cat's my best friend.
Yeah, the cat's bed is bigger than hers, just so you know.
Did we ever investigate the little pre-tower in the back?
Well, that's the one that the guards are where the bridge is. But no, not really, you haven't. But there's a lot of undead around that, though, as well. There was. That's one of the reasons you didn't.
Is it as steep as everything else?
Steeper. I mean, this area here is the only area that's even been remotely climbable with you, for you guys so far that you've seen.
Well, we know how well that went.
Well, in theory, it was not the worst idea in the world. You could succeed.
I don't know, taking all that fall damage.
It didn't feel good, that's for sure. I mean, you may be reluctant to try again, I don't know.
I'm not sure as hell is.
Go on, what arm can it do?
Shush.
How much suspense can we come up with for Shaggy to think about it?
Like, honestly, man, the only thing I'm thinking is wait until day, see if the drawbridge lowers. That's
what,
the only thing.
Are you gonna walk in the front door?
Literally, yes, I will literally walk in the front door with
Arya's
little
entire
spell
army
of possibly undead.
Hey, if the entire army is undead and you are obscured, the only thing you have to worry about is any intelligent undead.
Do you have any better ideas, guys?
Right up until the point where you find the necromancer and...
Yeah.
Or the entire army could be orcs. Like the... Or the... Not maybe orcs, but whatever those things are on the drawbridge, on the bridge there.
Right.
Well, we'll kill them all.
Yeah.
Look, that's the only thing I can think of right now, because other than climbing, and I don't want to climb again. That sucked.
Right.
So.
And if the drawbridge isn't down?
Figure out how we can get it lowered.
If the drawbridge isn't down, then my idea would be to return to town, buy some climbing gear, and try it again.
That's going to take you 6 days. Three there, three back.
Well, you know, Erasmus is taking his sweet time going to Orilla, so...
Yeah, but Orilla isn't going anywhere. Erasmus was saying...
Well, this keep isn't going anywhere.
The keep isn't. The army may be.
Oh, good. Then they'll leave, and then we don't have to fight them.
They'll leave with the necromancer and butcher and murder whatever else it was. Yep. That was the whole point of stopping them before they got up to whatever it is they were going to do. That was Erasmus' game plan. But hey, you can choose to do that.
We could.
What's one more thing on your conscience, right? So, Erasmus, about the necromancer, we didn't bother. We thought about it. Whatever.
Like, honestly, I don't have any other ideas, so...
Neo Gambit says, just a reminder, the last time you wasted this touch time, you opened a portal to hell that hasn't been closed. Just saying. Keep lollygagging. Bad shit's
pretty
gonna
much
happen.
Pretty much.
I don't know. Whatever you want to do. I have no idea.
That's what I want to do.
So you want to wait for daylight and see?
Yeah.
Yep.
Alrighty. This is not to see if the drawbridge is down. See if we roll under 25% or not. No, we did not. Okay, so... well, the drawbridge does not come down during the next day, but the army does not leave yet either.
Yet.
That's what I was rolling for, to see if they are already on their way. How prepared are they to do whatever it is that they're up to? Okay, so you're gonna spend another whole day. I guess you're gonna rest up again.
I guess, yeah.
Unless you're gonna stay awake for
unless someone else has 24 another hours.
Idea. I got nothing.
Okay. Right. Well, you guys all rest up, which means Arya has all of her spells back again.
I drink some potion.
Okay. So you wanna you're gonna brew an Arcana potion?
Yep.
Oh gosh, I was muted. I said I was gonna heal all of them before they went to bed.
Oh,
sorry.
Okay. Okay, so yeah, let's assume everybody's fully healed then. If Arya burns all of her spells before you all sleep. So, following day and night, so now it is another night. So you have now been here, this is your... got here the first night, watched all day, waited the second night, watched all day. So this is the third night, 3 days you've been here. So you run it, yeah, that fish, there's 7 days worth of fish. How does it seem so retarded now, does it, Veslar?
Yeah.
Because you all have like one fish each left. You're going to be hungry on the way home. No giant right. eagles coming to swoop and pick you up
well,
on the side of the mountain.
I mean, honestly, if we're going to be spending so many days, we're going to be circling the whole base as the forest allows.
Okay.
I mean, that's, like, honestly, we wouldn't just be wasting time, so...
Right, so you're gonna use the forest and basically do a complete circle of the place.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well...
Nice.
The only thing that really you see, other than absolutely no other viable way in, up here...
I accidentally closed my window. I'll be right back in.
Okay. And I'll wait. Okay.
No, I'm back.
Up here... seems to be possibly climbable, but definitely still not as easy as down here. So unless that drawbridge opens, your only two viable ways that you can see in is either here or up here.
And you said this is not as easy.
No, it's steeper.
And what about underneath the drawbridge? Like, if we could see...
If you go under here, that's pretty much going to be a sheer climb.
Oh, I was just wondering what these structures were.
They are broken pieces of wall. Like, where the wall originally... This was all stone that went across here at one point.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying? So, and that... It's all collapsed, so they built this wooden gangway instead.
Okay. I look at Piper and Arya and I say, well, we could try creating a ladder, you know? Yeah. Shearing some trees, branches, and stuff.
Yeah. Not bad.
Yeah.
My ladder skills are great.
100. Who has the crafting skill woodworking?
You know full well that it's entirely possible to do that. I mean,
absolutely,
it
is. I could build a 160-foot ladder in a 200-foot ladder in my sleep.
You just chop down a tree, right? And you know,
where's your axe?
With a heron.
I have
herons.
A hand axe.
You actually could chop down a tree with a heron. You all have one.
A herring? What? Okay.
Yeah, they were on a Monty Python kick earlier.
Oh, okay.
They're not just saying nay. They demand that they chop down the biggest tree in the forest with a herring at one point.
All right, well, it's not to waste more time. I mean, the only thing I can think of is to go back and get climbing gear and waste a bunch of days.
The ladder idea is not realistically viable.
Okay.
You're not going to make a... The ladder... You could possibly pull that off for a short 10, 15-foot ladder, but a 160-foot ladder is going to be entirely too flimsy to support you guys. Let's just be honest here.
So, Arya, if you have a way of helping us climb, I don't know. Otherwise, I'm not. I mean, we can risk climbing again, but that won't be fun. Because Piper and I are pretty much stuck on the ground, in a sense, you know?
I could blind you guys. I could.
This is where Arya just happens to mention, I have a flight spell.
You can sound burst me?
No, of course. If I had a way of helping you, I would have done it by now.
Yeah, Tess.
Yeah, Tess.
I don't know when you typed that to me, Shaggot, but yeah.
Oh, God. This is so stupid.
Yep. You get that. You got that, Gore, right?
Yeah. Okay. can you pick someone up with Mage Hand and drop them on the top of the wall? No. Mage Hand doesn't have the weight capacity of it. The Mage Hand could not elevate a person.
Well, Veslar, if you think that the army is undead, then we could always get Arya to summon a monster out front here, cause a commotion, hopefully get them to open that drawbridge, and use Arya's spell to get inside.
Let's do it. I am all for that idea.
If they're not undead...
She has obscuring mist too, right? We'll just be a giant moving cloud of obscurity.
Well, the mist.
But it's something we can do. It's something.
So
I like
that
idea.
So we could do hide from undead and obscuring mist.
Summon a monster, a thing, alive. Yeah.
But wouldn't the undead who wouldn't see us now see mist and be curious?
Yeah. No. It's one or the other. Because we don't know what kind of army is on the inside. If the army's undead, then do your undead thing. If not, well, let's at least go.
So just wait till we see it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Right, okay.
That makes sense. Okay.
Of course, you still have to get in there.
Summon a monster and how about we try and lure the skeleton in the front, where the drawbridge is, kill it, and then try to then lure it or whatever.
What?
Well, to get the drawbridge to come down, right?
Well, we don't want to be seen.
Yeah, the only way they're going to bring the drawbridge down, in theory, is if they...
If we are seen.
Right. Which case, that's probably the worst thing that you could possibly have happen.
Yeah.
An entire army comes out to greet you. Yes, the drawbridge is down, but... Of course, if they are all undead, the drawbridge comes down, the army of undead comes out, you disappear and run in behind them.
Yep.
If they're not, you are dead.
Pretty much.
Okay, So, yeah, we need to distract them. They have a reason to lower the drawbridge.
Yes.
So we need a distraction. What can we do to distract them?
Can get an animal to run in circles. could. Yeah.
Okay. Wait here, guys. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go along the outskirts all the way to the top.
Right. Could you please, whatever you're about to do, can it start with watch this? Okay, so you're going to go all the way, and of course that's not actually where you are because you're moving through the trees.
Yep, right.
Okay, so you head all the way up to the tree line up here.
And I'm going to use a lot... I'm going to use my flint and tinder.
Okay.
And I'm going to start burning some suckers down. Some trees.
You're going to need some fuel to go with that. But, I mean, you're in the forest. I mean, that's not
hard. I have flasks of oil and...
Okay, so you want to, light up a whole tree? Pour it all over the tree?
More than a tree. No, I want to light up a lot of trees.
Okay, so you literally want to create, a fire over here.
I want to create an inferno over there.
Okay. All right.
Burn, baby, burn.
And then while that's burning, go all the way around the bottom part, you know. Basically.
Okay.
To where Arya...
Yeah. Leave it alone. Stop hurting the cat.
Literally attacking the wall, so...
Okay. Let's get Veslar out of the way. All right, so you pretty much set all this these trees up here ablaze. And then you're going to make your way back down south.
Yep.
Okay. Well, it does draw the attention of the skeletons that are actually roaming around in the front. But much to your dismay, it doesn't seem to bother really anybody else. Nothing, I mean, no one comes out of the drawbridge. Nobody seems to really pay much attention to the flames.
And nobody's replaced the skeleton that we killed, or?
Nope. No, it's almost like the skeletons are just there. It's like, whatever. I mean, you know, as I said, they kind of just wander around by themselves, doing nothing, really.
Hmm.
It's like they're almost like an afterthought.
Right, just like sprinkled around.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, whatever it is that's going on in that fortress, they don't seem to be overly concerned, at least at this point, by the flames. Which within
let
itself
us in, let
weird.
Us in.
So along the hills, further to the west, there's like no skeletons, no nothing, right? Where the drawbridge gets lowered?
Not now, no.
Okay.
But of course, anybody that's up on the battlements or in any of the towers could see right. clearly that but way, yeah.
Have we seen people on the battlements?
No, you have not. In fact, the only things, other than these undead, these skeletons roaming around the outside, the only thing you've seen is the four humanoids on that makeshift bridge between right. the two.
And how high up is that drawbridge?
That would be
that
160 feet straight up.
Okay. I say we go back and get some climbing gear. Plan didn't work. I have no other ideas.
6 days.
Can we make spikes somehow with wood?
No.
No.
Wood will not hammer into the rock particularly
it's
well.
Rock. Well, you know.
I mean, what you were doing before was not the worst idea in the world. I will say that.
Was until I almost died.
Dems the rolls, though, right?
Where's our traveling blacksmith?
Right.
Yeah, there should be random merchants that just spawn, right?
ridiculously placed NPCs like in World of Warcraft every once in a while. Like, why is that guy even there?
That's funny.
Okay.
Yeah. I told you my idea, so.
Okay, let's do it. I say.
Piper?
Well, I think our only choice is to go get climbing gear, but the army is probably totally going to be gone, like Vesslar said. Or Shirasmus.
Mm-hmm. Shirasmus. Do you want... Oh, where's your owl at, by the way?
Shirasmus has him.
Erasmus has him. Okay. I mean Erasmus.
Mm-hmm.
I was thinking maybe someone... No. We're not splitting up the party. We're terrible.
We could wait for the army to vacate and try an assassination.
Yeah.
Probably.
If you do that, though, that means they're ready. They're battle ready. So they're as strong as they're going to be.
Oh, definitely.
Magic Kingpin, thanks for the follow.
Yeah.
White. 1, 2, 3.
Or
three,
we can try climbing
five.
Again. I
or
mean, we
white
can
leaked.
Give that another go. We gotta do something.
We need more security. Do you have... You have the spear. Let me see if I have any equipment I can use.
I have nothing that can be used for climbing.
A dagger. I have one dagger. And a pickaxe. Can you use those things?
Is he not working?
You dig underneath.
Dig, you dig. Oh, yes.
Why are you not working?
What's not working, Gar?
Oh, no, sorry.
See, even if we climb the rock face to 160 feet successfully, we don't know if there's a there's not necessarily a foothold or a ledge where it goes sheer, right? Yeah. To stand up against? Because then we have to climb 40 feet sheer. Like, it just doesn't seem practical with what we got.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
Okay.
We're wasting time here, so.
Okay. We could try climbing once more.
I don't think it's a good idea. But if you guys want to, we can.
I don't know.
I don't want to, but.
I don't want to either. And we surveyed the entirety of the perimeter of this place already?
Pretty much, yep.
Okay, and that was the shortest one?
That is the only one. That is the place where the cliff face is the most angled.
It's a little tilted. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, your difficulty to climb here is lower than anywhere else.
Okay.
At the top of where the cliffs go to the wall, is there a place to like rest or anchor in, or is it just does it just go into the wall?
Well, I mean, it comes up and it butts up to the wall, but it looks like there's probably a little bit of an area there that you could kind of rest and hang out. I mean, it wouldn't be like a place to actually like camp out as such, but. You know, once you were there, it would be easier to climb the wall at that point, yes.
Mm-hmm.
It's a lot of climbing, because each one's 45 feet, right?
Mm-hmm.
What if instead of both of us going up this time, one person goes up, anchors, climbs more, anchors, climbs more, anchors. And you ever seen when people wall climb, mm-hmm. one person stands on the ground and holds the rope, so if they fall, they can... use their body weight to counter the fall.
Belay.
Yes.
Yep.
What are we using to anchor? I got my staff. What else?
Thus
pickaxe?
Far. Yeah. I mean, thus far, the one thing that you have that really did seem to hold your weight pretty well was that magical spear.
Right. Which I'd put at 80 feet because that's halfway. So.
We have a pickaxe. I have a dagger. Arya has a dagger. You have two daggers.
All right. I guess I'll climb. I'll do it again.
All right, so you guys
get this over with, man.
Wait till night, and you're gonna get to the bottom. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right, Vesh.
Fucking.
Plus two.
Yep. Let's do this.
Do it. Do it. Wait.
14.
Oh. Shoot. I was gonna. Oh.
What was you gonna do?
I prepared a spell. Guidance, it gives you like plus one to skill point.
Okay, so.
So you 15. Cast that before? Okay, in that case,
yeah.
With that, yes, you make it up 45 feet. 15 is what you need to not.
And
fall.
Again, I have the rope tied to my waist as I'm going up.
Right.
Alright.
Just don't die, it's fine.
Well, right now he's, you know.
Falling this distance isn't the problem. Alright.
Yeah, it's when he gets higher up he's got to worry about it.
Yeah. So that's 45 feet I climbed?
Yep.
All right, climbing up again.
Well, actually, no, it'd be 50 feet. Because you don't have... You've got all the rope slack, right? So you can...
Yeah.
You don't have to... Okay, so you're now 100 feet.
That's... Okay. I'm going to do the spear thing on a crevice or something.
Okay, strength check. With a plus two.
Oh, so that's plus six then.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so it's 10.
Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. Right. Well, the spear is in there. Not as far as it was before, but it's in.
Tie that off with the slack I got
okay.
going.
Yep.
And then I guess I'll just go again.
All right.
Fuck. This is where it gets scary.
Oh God, you fell.
14.
You fall. Let's see. Okay. Yep. You made 20 feet up there. Okay, you slip, The spear does hold your weight. You take 2 points of damage.
And then by the spear again, right?
Yes. So you still, so you still only one climb away, pretty much. One and a bit climbs away from the top.
Could I try to make the spear further in, since I?
If you wish, yeah. Of course you can. You can take it out and jam it back in again.
Yeah, I'm gonna definitely try that because I got a sense of how much it could hold me by my fall right there. Right.
Right. Yeah.
All right. So plus strength check again. Plus one, you said.
Plus two.
Oh, plus two, so plus six, okay. So this is for the spear again.
Okay.
Yay.
There you go.
Ooh.
Okay. Oh, there you go, okay. So this time you really kind of like use all your body weight to smash it in there, and it like really digs into the rock. It's in further than last time.
All right.
You feel very comfortable that this spear is not going to come out easily.
Okay. Son of a bitch. All right, let's go, guys. Roll again.
24, okay. So with a 24, you are only 10 foot from the top of the rock face.
Oh, wow. All
right, so I got to do the final push, right?
Well,
Hold
on, because you only have 150 foot of rope, so...
Got it, that's right.
So at this point, you either have to... You can go all the way, but then someone else is going to have to climb, like, 15 feet to get to the bottom of the rope before they can use the rope to start climbing.
You can do that.
Yeah, I'm going to have that because that's just from the bottom, right? Yeah. So that makes...
Well, it's more sense because then if they do fall, they're not falling far. Okay.
They're not falling super far.
Go for it. Here we go.
Son of a bitch!
Make this dice roll.
Shit.
A 10.
Oh my god.
So close.
Alright.
Oh wow.
Well, you do come stumbling, you come tumbling back down, you take 5 points of damage. The spear holds you without hardly moving whatsoever.
Okay.
So you're basically just, you gotta remake that other climb.
Jeez. This is so sucky.
16.
Right, you're back up to the top of that. You've only got 10 feet to go again. The second time, you're only 10 foot from the top.
Oh my god.
Well, strong, please nerf.
I give up. I just give the fuck up. I'm done. I think we should go to the hills and just say, yoo-hoo,
you take a point of damage and it still holds.
Keep going, Bess. Keep going.
Yep, doing it again.
Okay.
There you go. He's back to that shit.
Back to that same spot. You're like one good 15. Dice roll away. There 15. You go. Just made it. Finally. You know what? That was a bigger. That has been more of a tough. That wall has been.
Fucking hate this. Deserves this. Shit, this. Man. Fucking hate this shit. This is the most annoying thing I've ever had to do in D&D.
Man,
climb the cliffs, man. Just do it, dude.
Well, you do certainly like to make things difficult.
I do.
Well,
I really, really
one
do.
Of us up.
Right, well, Veslar is up. Okay, so what's your game plan now you're at the top, Ves?
Okay, so there's a ledge. I can stand against the wall,
yes,
right?
Yes, you got about a two-foot ledge, so you can have your back to the wall.
Is there a way to... 2 feet, you said, so it's not that much. Okay.
No, it's about, 2 foot.
So, is there something I could anchor, like, my daggers into the ground and tie the rope to?
You certainly could do that. You could stab the daggers down, like, both of them, and tie the rope to that.
Tie the rope to both of them, so mm-hmm. the rope is, like, completely attached?
Yep.
So they have to climb, what, like, 17 feet, maybe, to the mm-hmm. rope?
Yeah.
And then climb just using the rope?
At that point, they can use the rope, which will give them a plus 5.
Good.
Okay, so I'm going to do that.
And if they tie themselves off on the rope, well, plus the spear is there, which is halfway, so whoever comes up last.
Yep.
Nikor, okay. Thanks for the follow. And White. Actually, I think I got you already, yeah. All right, so who's going up second, then?
Probably me.
Okay, so you have the first climb roll you're going to have. You need a 15, and you can use your dagger, so that'll give you plus 1. But you can't exactly fall. In fact... We're not... Yes. You make that no problem. So you are to the bottom of the rope.
So I'll tie myself off.
Okay, now you have +5 on the climb skill.
And do I get 1 for the dagger still?
Probably not, because you're going to be holding onto the rope instead of using the dagger. You'd be sacrificing the rope for the dagger at that point.
That's fine.
All right, +5. Okay, nice. So climb up.
Hey! There you go.
You're on your way up. You're 100 feet. 145 feet. And once you get to that point, Veslar can kind of help you up the last few feet anyway. Okay, you're up, no problem.
Okay, I guess now you just have to get
Arya up there.
I will also use my dagger. Yeah.
Untie the rope and just pull it up.
Good idea.
Okay, so Arya, you're gonna use your dagger. You can get +1 for the dagger for the first climb. And then after that, it's +5.
Nope.
Okay, you take 2 points of damage.
Okay. Okay. Second attempt.
No!
I see a butterfly.
Another 2 points of damage.
Butterfly! Billy!
What's that? Okay.
Just do it!
Shit.
Okay, you know what? This is painful. Eventually you climb it.
Okay, then how many points of damage should I take?
Just take an average of 4 and you get up to the rock. Okay, now you got a +5. We'll be here all day. Go for it.
+5.
Yeah, wall too strong. Please nerf.
But at this point, woo! Okay. They could damn it. The two of them could pull you up as much as you weigh.
Yeah. Oh, true.
But keep climbing anyway, because that's not happening. Go for it.
Oh my gosh.
God.
Yep. Pretty much.
I mean, if they're pulling up the slack as you go, when you do fall, you're not going to fall far.
I'm good.
You're up. So all of you are now finally at
that
the top
what,
of the ledge. The wall is the toughest opponent you have had to face so far is this wall.
And now we have a 40-foot sheer
so
wall
embarrassing.
To climb.
Oh, okay.
Did Arya get the spear on the way up?
Sure.
Yeah, pull that spear out. Let's see a strength check.
Pull it up. Okay, strength check.
Do it.
Veslar rammed it in there with a total of what? What was it?
It was a lot, man. It was like
24, I think.
Yeah, 24. You need a 20 to be able to pull that out, Arya.
Oh, jeez. Nope, 15.
No. Okay, you can't get it out.
Oh, sorry.
So the spear is in the wall. And Veslar, would you like to climb down and pull it out?
Nope.
No,
we're good,
nope,
man.
Would not like to do that.
This is our escape. Although to be fair, we have no way of climbing a 40-foot wall. Just FYI, guys.
Well, you have the rope.
Yeah, but
you actually. Well, I'm not gonna say anything.
How tall are you guys?
You gonna make a people pile?
I am 5'10".
I'm gonna say you've got about 16 feet of people pile.
Yeah, I'm 6 feet exactly.
5'1".
Yeah. You got about 15 feet of people.
Let's just untie one of those.
I don't know that I would want to stand 2 abreast with only a 2 foot.
I am not going to be a human rope.
Arya's fairly.
Arya, do you have the ability to use force with your mage hands?
Force?
Like if we tie the rope to an end of a dagger, can you levitate the rope up with the dagger and slam the dagger into the ground? Is that something that you can do?
No.
I don't think so.
Mage hand will allow her to levitate any object up to basically 20, up to 5 pounds in weight. It has, her range is 5 foot per 2 level. So at level 9, that's 35 plus 25. She can levitate as high as 60 feet and she can move it 15 feet in any direction from that point.
Can she, manipulate it to tie it around something and make it a knot?
Absolutely. Well, She can manipulate it to go around something. She's not going to be able to put any force behind it to secure it, though.
Okay. So well, how about this then? The rope's one big long rope. Is there anything that we could loop it around and have it come back down so we have two ropes?
Absolutely. Yeah. You've got the battlements at the top. The battlement, like the the actual square piece of rock that pokes up, is about 6 feet wide. So you just have to go up 40 feet, around 6 feet, back down 40 feet, 86 feet. You have plenty of rope to do that.
Great.
Okay. So that's what we're going to do, guys.
So
good job.
There you go. So who is going... So you're going to mage hand the rope up?
Yes.
Okay.
Do you want me to do some
kind of
check?
No.
That's a lot of feats. Mage hands...
Well, no, the problem is mage hand, as I said, maximum weight of 5 pounds. As soon as you've got that rope is 40 foot of rope weighs more than, what is 40 foot of rope weigh?
That's true, man. Rope weighs a lot.
It's not, as it starts to go up, it'll get maybe 5 feet off the ground and it won't be able to go any higher. The idea is, in theory, we could try to throw it.
How about you summon a flying creature to carry the rope up there?
Do you have with your monster summoning, do you have a flying creature that's available?
Let's see here.
For Aria, the range on mage hand is 60, 65 feet, something like that.
Let's see. A hippogriff? A bat?
It's a simple question of weight ratio. A 2-pound bat cannot carry a 40-pound rope.
Yeah, I'm just reading things that fly here. How big is a hippogriff, though?
Oh, more than big enough. Hippogriff is
big. Yeah, they would...
We could probably ride the fucking hippogriff to the top.
You probably could. The only problem with that, of course, a hippogriff will stick out like a sore thumb for anybody that's over there. But that's not...
I don't know if I should summon a hippogriff right now.
Do you have a flying monkey? That would be awesome.
A fiendish centipede.
Hey, that's my vote.
Fiendish centipede.
That's really funny.
Yeah, hippogriff is basically kind of, a hippogriff is like the body of a horse, head of an eagle, and big ass wings.
What about like an eagle?
And they can carry up to 300 pounds.
I didn't see an eagle.
For a light load, medium 600.
You have summon monster 1 or 2?
3.
Oh, you have 3?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Okay. You have 3.
Why don't we try throwing it very skillfully?
Well, see, the problem with that is you use the word skillfully in there.
Okay, here's a question.
Rope use is what you would do.
If you shot the rope up with an arrow and had it just kind of land... Then, because the end that you're going to have to move is not very much, could you mage hand that around and then drop it and gravity will bring it down the rest?
Okay. I have to be able to see it, though, right?
Oh, yeah. Does she have to be able to see the end?
Yeah.
How about we take the two ends of the rope and we, like, toss it, like, swing it like a... Like
that's a
rope.
It's a lot of feet. Have you ever tried to throw a rope that far?
No.
Yeah, hurling a rope up 40 feet is it's a long way.
Any of the monsters able to climb the wall?
Do you have a spider monkey?
They come at you like a spider monkey.
I mean, had some different
Sloth
snakes.
Can climb good.
Got a 20-foot average gator lying around.
Bear, bison, badger... Ape, fiendish ape. Yeah.
Conclair, thanks for the follow.
Snakes? I have no idea what can
climb. Here's the thing.
A centipede can climb a wall.
Damn straight it could.
It's a huge centipede.
It could easily climb that wall, and it could easily carry that rope.
Oh, please, let's do it.
Centipede power.
New dimension, you get 50 XP.
Let's do it. Let's.
I'm deducting 50 EXP from the party and giving it to New Dimension. There you go.
I think that's a wise choice.
All right. So, is that what you want to do?
Yeah. It says here it can climb 40 feet. Mm-hmm. Perfect.
What are the odds?
I can climb exactly the amount we
That's
need.
Really funny.
It gets to the very top and it's like, oh, you overestimated. It's 40 feet and 6 inches. I'm just shy, guys.
I can't make it.
I cannot make it.
I don't have the power.
Let's summon that thing. Let's do it.
What's his name, guys?
Yeah, the centipede has to have a name.
Pedo.
I think the centipede should be called New Dimension.
You're right.
ND the centipede.
Right.
Okay, summoned.
Here he is. Look at him. There's ND.
Adorable. Okay, here's the rope. Go. Go bring it around the battlement there, centipede.
Okay, so you... So the centipede crawls up, wraps itself, like wiggles around, and then scales back down, bringing the rope with it. Congratulations, centipede.
And
you have
achieved
victory.
And I'm going to put the centipede on my back so he can come with us.
Dangerous. Okay. What's the duration on it? Because monster summoning does not last very long.
Right.
By the time it climbs 40 feet, comes back down, I don't know that you'll have much there anyway. By the time you get up there, it's going to be gone, so don't worry about it.
Okay, fine.
ND does his job, man. It's all good.
There you go.
Yeah.
All right. So there is now a looping rope up and over.
Oh, yes.
Okay. So this is what we're going to do, guys. Since it's looping, I will be on one side. Like a pulley, I will pull you up.
Either you or Piper are way strong enough to do that and carry the dead weight of the other person, no problem.
Awesome.
Because it's a pulley, so...
Yeah.
Cool.
And there's 100 foot of rope, so 40 feet up, 40 foot down, it's 80, it's 20 foot.
Yep.
Like, awesome. It's not going to, like, slip over, right?
No. Yet. I mean, the dip in the battlements, like, from where the lower part is to where the top part is, it's like, you know, like 5 or 6 feet. So it would have to slip over 6 foot of rock. Ain't happening.
Okay.
Doesn't mean someone on the other side isn't going.
Of course,
going...
the one that we went around is brittle of, like, all the way through in the back.
There's a goblin on the other side doing this to the rope as we speak.
All right. I'm going to do that.
So
Piper,
who are you
first.
Pulling up first?
I'll
pull up
Piper
first.
Any pluses?
Right. You don't need to make a climb roll. He's strong.
I am literally pulling you up.
You have, what, an 18 strength?
Yeah, man. Yeah. 18.
Okay.
I'm Piper, strong.
What can Piper see once she's on the other side?
I don't want to know what Piper can see.
Okay, Piper. Now, as you appear across the top, looking down into the courtyard, you can clearly see a well-armored orc standing, like, here with his back to the wall, right here, which is from where you are. It's about, ooh. Yeah, it's 120 feet. Oh, it's about 110 feet. But he doesn't really seem to be... He's literally, like, just slumped against the wall. It's like, I'm on guard duty for a place... Well, at a place that's never going to get sieged. No one could ever climb these walls.
So I'm going to, on seeing him, I'm going to lean over and I'm going to, you know, gesture and say, shh.
Okay.
How far down? Well, I don't know how far down that is.
40 feet. The other side of the wall.
Oh, that's the other side of the wall. 40 feet. Okay.
Okay. I'm going to climb up.
Okay.
Yeah, so I'm going to do that for Arya.
You hoist Arya up to the top. Right. On the other side of the wall, basically there's like a five or six foot walkway. It's in ill repair in places, but it is still there. So, I mean, you guys are actually, like, you can be on the top of the walkway, kind of just crouched down, peering down over the edge.
So how are you guys going to get me up?
Both pull?
Piper can pull him up by herself. She's got an 18 strength as well.
Yeah.
All right. So what are you guys doing with the rope? Taking it with you? Are you going to leave it here or what?
We should leave it.
I was going to say for now, leave it where it is.
Right.
Well, here's the thing. If we come back this way, great. If we don't, we lose our rope.
Yeah.
What are the chances we're going to sneak out?
Well, wait. Okay. No, we put one half of it on the bottom side. So it's going literally 40 feet up and 40 feet down. Right?
Whee! You can do that.
Can we wrap it? Oh, that's 6 feet. So we could wrap it around what we used to climb up and have it be for both sides.
There you go. That'll work.
That works? That makes sense?
Right, just for giggles and grins.
Sure. Spear.
There's a spear. Look at that spear. Look, stuck there
in
the rock.
Beautiful.
Okay. It's a magical spear. Yes.
All right. So you do want to leave the rope in place.
Right. But being on both sides of the wall, that's the ultimate plan.
Okay. So it's hanging down.
So if we need to run and climb back out, we can.
Gotcha. Okay. That makes sense.
Okay.
What can we not see over here, like being on the battlements?
That's inside of a tower. The wall that you're seeing here, I can give you a little bit more wall.
Okay, I got it.
But basically, yeah, what you're seeing is like... There you go. Yeah, that's... You see, this is the wall, and this is actually like the wall of a tower, so you can't see inside it. That's
and we
solid
can't
wall.
Skirt along that thing, right?
No. No, you can go this way. Like, you can follow the battlement along this way.
Well, we gotta get down there, don't we? I mean, without him seeing us. Arya.
Yeah, I'm gonna cast it now. Is that what you want?
What do you cast?
Send the centipede to distract him.
Oh, never mind. Oh,
no, wait.
Wait. Can't you just hold person him?
If he's not undead.
He's not, he's an orc. It's obvious.
Oh, it's an orc?
Yep.
I don't want to waste...
A pretty big, muscly son of a bitch,
too. I should save that spell for the necromancer.
And just to point out, I mean, I mentioned it, but just to verify, he is well-armed and well-armored. Like, he's not wearing what... You know, orcs are usually wearing rag-taggy crap that they got.
So this is, like, an important orc.
This guy has got a full suit of armor, a shield, and a big fuck-off axe. Not crappy orc wear. This guy was... Somebody kitted this guy out.
Okay.
We can't like jump on him. That's 40 feet. We'll hurt ourselves, right?
Maybe a little.
I mean, or
him.
Piper.
I can only do it 3 times.
Okay, all right. Piper, what if you and I both jump on him from above?
Yeah.
Just like crush him.
Right. Actually, before you do that, let me, because I'm forgetting, you have got the moonlight. So I should actually give you a little bit more visibility than you have.
Big fuck off facts.
Right, okay. You can't see them clearly, but there are 2 orcs over here as well.
Oh.
You would see, I mean, as I say, you wouldn't make out the features, but you'd see the figures sitting over there. So bear in mind, you know, if you drop down here, they may see you.
Well, what if
they
what
look?
If
we... Can we tell they kind of look just as armored?
Oh yeah, this guy right here has a big two-handed axe that's probably at least half as big as an average two-handed axe. And this guy, again, he has a one-handed axe and a shield. Every orc has a helmet. They're wearing like chainmail. I mean, they're properly geared out.
They all bear the white hand of Sauron.
Right, that's right.
What is this, a grate? What is that?
It is a metal grate, yes.
So there probably is an underground irrigation system and there's a tunnel that leads to it.
Sewers!
Quite possibly.
Yay!
It just wasn't in this 20-foot area or 60-foot area that Arya searched.
Oh, man.
I'm going to point at that grate and then I'm going to look at Arya and be like, what about that?
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
It was actually, yeah, Arya searched the 2 areas right here. It was here. Oh!
She was
one
shot
out from
it,
finding it. No. Okay, but yeah, it is like a rusted iron grate.
What if we lure the thing underneath us and then
Okay, we go back down the wall. We find the sewer entrance and we come down. No, I'm just kidding.
We lure the thing underneath us and then we drop down on it. 40 feet, yeah.
Okay, lure, go ahead and lure it.
Now, remember, these orcs are facing in your direction.
And they could probably see the whole courtyard, right?
Yeah.
Orcs see very well in the dark, yeah.
I have obscuring mists. We could use that now.
How many times can you use that?
Let's see. 4 times.
Might not be a bad idea.
Cast obscuring mist on the courtyard below, and then climb down the rope.
Yeah.
Silently.
Yeah.
All right. That's what we'll do.
So you're going to cast obscuring mist on the courtyard?
Well, it moves, right? Why don't we cast it on Arya? So it moves with Arya.
That would probably make more sense.
Okay. Well, not unless she goes down last. She'd have to go down first, but then... Okay, whatever you guys
want. I'll cast it on
basically, it will cover 20 foot wide and 20 foot high, so the 20 foot of covering. I mean, if it's on Arya, she will be covered the entire way down.
Yeah.
Once she's on the bottom, you guys wouldn't be covered for the first 20 feet of the climb down.
Ooh.
Unless you somehow can all go down together, which...
Can't you cast it on the rope?
Yeah.
So the rope radiates the all down?
Yeah, but then we got to bring
again,
the rope
only 20 feet of it, though.
Oh.
Like, imagine a 20-foot diameter ball.
Mm-hmm. Well, if we don't make any noise coming down, you know.
Okay, let's do it.
Do it.
Okay, so what's the game plan?
We're gonna cast it on me.
Well, we're not gonna do any of those things because it's the end of our stream, and we'll figure it out next week.
What a stream. So stupid.
Hi there, I'm Gorbad, the Dungeon Master on How We Roll, and if you'd like to follow my personal channels, you can do so at twitch.tv/Gorbad, or follow me on Twitter at Gorbad.
Are you the victim of magical malpractice? Is your neighbor a cultist attempting to summon an evil god? Do you know of a crazy elven sorceress who casts fireball constantly, endangering innocent lives? If you answered yes to any of the questions above, you need me, Veslar Noleth, Witch Hunter Extraordinaire. Contact me at aneb_convos on Twitter or twitch.tv/shaggot. Magic is wrong. Do the right thing.
Hi guys, I'm Bane. If you'd like to hang out with me some more, come chill in my own personal stream at twitch.tv/Bane1271 or toss me a follow over on Twitter, YouTube, and Facebook at Bane Blackstar. I hope to see you soon.
My name is Jane. I don't stream very much, but you can follow me on the Twitters over there. That's all I really got to say, so I guess this is goodbye. Peace, suckers.